Hello everyone. In this video, we'll talk about the ins and outs of the role of a software tester, a role that requires a good eye, a lot of patience, and a deductive mind. This is the Sherlock Holmes of software development. Ready to find out more? Let's start by describing what a software tester does. Or should I say, software test engineer? Pretty sure the role is called quality assurance tester. No wait, I know, the QA tester. Actually, those are all the terms that are used to describe this one and same role in a software company.
Potato.
The main responsibility of a software tester is to make sure that the software built by developers runs according to the client's requirements. There are all sorts of ways to do that. And the one that people usually imagine is simply trying out how the software works with different data inputs and usage scenarios. Something like this. A software tester walks into a bar, runs into a bar, crawls into a bar, dances into a bar, flies into a bar, jumps into a bar, and orders a beer, two beers, zero beers, 99 million beers, a lizard in a beer glass, minus one beer, QWERTY beers. While this is how most people imagine software testing and how a lot of software is being tested, hence the stereotype and joke, there's much more to the job of a great software tester. First, there are many different types of tests. Some tests hunt for bugs and defects, some for performance issues under different types of loads, some check if the software is secure enough, some test the basic logic of the solution and whether it makes sense in the first place, and some are simple explorations through the software to see if we can find issues or improvement opportunities. Second, there are different ways how tests are run. People mostly imagine software testers sitting in front of a computer and using new software builds to find bugs. This would be manual testing. Most of the tests being run in reality are automated tests, which are small programs that test other programs. Many of these tests are being written not by developers, but by software testers. Sooner or later, great testers need to learn to code, and that can be a great foundation for their professional careers. We'll get back to that in a minute. Finally, there's a moment when tests are conceived. Exploratory testing can happen only after the software has been put together. But most of the test scenarios can be written up front, during interviewing, requirement gathering, and design phases. This makes software testers integral to the early stages of the development as well, not just the final ones. Now that we've clarified that there's more to testing than stereotypes, let's see what you need to bring before becoming a software tester. We studied many open positions and compiled this list. So you'd need a bachelor's degree in computer science.
I went to college!
Or a related field. You'd also need knowledge of software test design and testing methods. And most importantly, working knowledge of test techniques and compatibility with various software programs. Let's not forget the really important skills. Communication skills, critical thinking skills, good organizational skills, detailed-oriented mindset. I told you, you really need to be a Sherlock Holmes for this one. A Sherlock Holmes with a working knowledge of programming. Elementary. The great thing about software testers is that this role can be a stepping stone to a career in the software industry. This role can lead you to a project management role or a software developer role, should you choose to go down those paths. Now, let's not forget the really important bit, how much you'd be paid as a software tester. According to PayScale, the average pay is $56,468, which is a really decent figure, but it's an average. If you embrace software testing as your career and master the job through constant self-improvement and learning, you can expect much higher compensation than average. You'll have to learn to code, interview, research, and document, and see the software product as a whole, not just bits of it. And as such, you'll become much more valuable to organizations that you join. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you in the next one.